Hare Krishna. The most exhausting burden is a mask. Sometimes, if we see somebody carrying a huge burden, maybe somebody is carrying a huge bag on their back or a huge box on their head, we pity them a little bit. Oh, how tired they will get. How much of a burden they are carrying. Yes, that burden is difficult to carry, but there are some burdens which are invisible and yet they are heavier still. One of the heaviest burdens, one of the most exhausting burdens is a mask. Normally we would think of a mask to be a very light thing. And sometimes in fancy dress competitions or on some other events when people dress up in different ways, disguise themselves, we put on a mask and we may feel it's barely any weight. We are not talking here about physical masks. We are here talking about the appearance that we put on before the world. Now, sometimes we may actually have a lot of distress, unhappiness in our life, and still we put on a facade of happiness. Now, it doesn't mean that we, if we have unhappiness in life, we should always be with a long face, morose looks, radiating depression all around. But if we pretend to be what we are not, without having any place where we can honestly be ourselves, then that is surely a problem. We will not be able to function for long like that. We have to be who we are. Of course, there are undesirable attributes in us which need to be corrected. But correcting them will require effort. It will require time. And we will have to take them one step at a time. We have to move from where we are. But if we keep pretending to be what we are not, that leads to, that becomes a burden. Oh, you know, in front of this person, I have to act like this. We have to keep doing a performance constantly. Say sports players or say media people, those who are in the entertainment industry, often they have to, you know, smile and laugh and look very happy. That's a part of their PR profile. But then they also need to be, they also very much value their privacy, because they need some time when they can put off the face that they're putting on in front of the world. Now this applies even more to not just happiness, but also to morality. The Bhagavad Gita says that karmendriyani sanyamya yasate manasa smaran indriyarthan vimudhatma mithyacharaha sa uchyate. If somebody controls the external senses of action, that means they don't engage in sensual activities, yasate manasa smaran, but in their mind indriyarthan, they are constantly remembering the sense objects, craving to enjoy them, scheming to enjoy them, then mithyacharaha sa uchyate, such a person is a mithyachari, is a hypocrite. And such a person, they cannot put on that face for long. Although some people may just conceal their wrongs for a very long time, but the fact is that putting on that mask, trying to be two-faced, it is a very exhausting task. Now, in front of, in public, we try to appear to be saintly, and in private, then we may be greedy, we may be violent, we may be sexually rabid almost. And this will drain us. It is far more productive if we can just simply be who we are. That doesn't mean that we be publicly sinful. It's just that we don't try to put on a bigger facade. Yes, there is always going to be a distance between our practice and our principles, our precept. But we should be trying to bridge that gap, not perpetuate that gap and cover up that gap. So when there is honesty and humility, then we'll find that there is the path to spirituality becoming much easier, because we'll be able to be where we are in peace, and we'll be able to move forward from where we are in honest, sincere, small but significant steps. Thank you. Hare Krishna.